話してるから
。
This is our last video. We're gonna do a reflection video for this, this video. And I guess I'm gonna start. I'm Rahim. My matrix number is 191479.
Hi, I'm Thomas. Matrix number 195548.
Hi, my name is Mike.
Hello, my name is Ziad Ashraf, matrix number 191588.
Hello, my name is Hamid Rasul. I'm signed my mission is 195002.
Hi, my name is Amira Misalbarajo. My matrix number is 193741.
Hi, my name is Shazara Nabila and my matrix number is 190144.
Hi, my name is Lin Shosh. Matrix number is 186461.
Okay, so let us know, like, we're going to review this video, which one the language that the camera that we did, and at the end we're gonna rate which one is the best game in English game that we did. So let's start with the first week. We played your game. Yeah. What's called?
Dictionary.
Charades.
Opinions on trades.
So ladies first. What is your take on charades?
The pros and cons of charades.
She is the one that we have to guess.
Yeah.
A lot.
I think it helps us to think more harder because not all of us will know what are the basic three.
What's your take?
On charades?
Yeah.
There were some pros and cons of charades.
Pros were?
Well, the innovative creativeness in charades was phenomenal. I really liked it.
What about the acting of the people? How would you rate it?
We're not actors, we're students, so that should be.
Was it fun?
The fun was definitely in all the games. In all the games that we went through, the experience it was amazing for me. It was fun. The fun was there, definitely. I enjoyed every minute of our games that we played. It's truly upsetting when this is the last video. But we're talking about charades. It involved a lot of physical communication. I think that's something that's I think not only specific for English language. Physical language can be used anywhere. So the game charades we play, we can use it in any other language as well. It's so general and so common. That's one of the beauties of charades. It's just communication between any kind of language you have.
What do you think about how easy the game was? How we needed it?
It was a bit hard to act. I mean, the 30 seconds that you guys gave me to think of how to act, that was the best thing. And the worst part, I guess, that we were like children trying to spell words like something like that. Yeah. So yeah, that's it.
I acted. Yeah. And I guess you're the character that you chose. Yeah. So I'm very proud of it.
Thomas, what is your take on partnerships?
Well, I share the same point as Hamid, that it is a general language. Like body language is something that is understood universally. So it's not necessarily something that taught us English, but more like taught us a better way of communication. So.
Yeah. That's the thing. The first thing is that it's the most interesting thing is explain about the language and also we use our body language to explain what we want to explain the games. And in these games, we also know each other's role because before that, we didn't know each other. But in these games, we use body language or we express the words, then we know each other's
input. I think it was a very easy game to arrange because we don't need pens, papers, not much. Like, all we needed to think of and play to the other guy and he acts. So all you need is a person, like people to play it. So it's quite an easy game to even arrange as a game master. I don't admit that I was a game master.
As all game masters.
So we heard the opinions of everyone. Let's move on to the next game.
Which was Pictionary.
Now, so you want to say anything?
About Pictionary?
It's
fun
plus
creativeness.
Okay,
that's fun. So, second game, I was the game master, it was the Pictionary. In this game, I lost horribly, so. Not always winning, yeah. So, in this game, like, we technically draw and try to follow other people to guess. So, what do you think, guys, like, about Pictionary?
I think it's
fun.
It was fun because we had the whole thing set up, like the projector and stuff. So, it was really fun because the way we had to think, like, we had to do the word without doing the word.
Draw the word without.
It was quite hard, but we won.
We did win, yes. I got to the word.
So as Hamid said in the previous video, like in the previous video, we used our acting to, in here we used to draw, which is also universal, like to communicate with people, and we transfer it like to words, which is really nice.
Yeah, like charades, I believe this is also a very general game. Despite the languages we speak, drawing, just by seeing, look at it, specifically that we use animals as our main topic of interest, was any language you speak of, you can actually understand that and enjoy the game through the process of it. That's one of the biggest pros of this game, Pictionary, through visualization.
Way of communication, or it's a good way to know how people think. So if someone draws something, you can guess it, or you can try to guess it, not only in English, but still in English. So this makes it easy for you to guess, or kind of easy.
Right.
No, you had to
keep score.
Like,
it's not that hard to do.
as maybe the game master, the control of the game.
Yeah, I mean, it's just coming up with stuff.
Yes, but it's a very personality based game. You think of it sometimes, you think of it on the spot.
Yeah. So it's quite easy to play also. Like,
depending on how you know
play.
Another person, the game can be more interesting.
Yeah, I think it's fine. And. Okay. And it makes us know each other more a little bit.
Why are you looking at me?
A little bit.
More is not better. More is not better.
Yes, more is not
more.
Got more. I do not need to know.
I didn't really need to know more. Not really.
Yeah. What's your
thing? You guys, any thoughts on the game 2% Alive?
It's really I think high also because we
that
didn't
yes,
know
it's
we
knew the each other.
Yeah.
It's better be like Sherlock Holmes.
Yes. think I'm the only one who looks at this academic wide.
Well, now let's just look at the entertainment.
Then we go to the academy again.
Can I choose to be?
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not.
Finally, the smartest person here.
Yeah, because I think in this experience, you should think a lot about the sentence you use.
Okay, for entertainment, what do we agree on? Pictionary or Hangman?
Pictionary.
Entertainment-wise, I think Pictionary would be better because there's a lot of laughs.
Yeah.
When you see people drawing and you can't really draw that thing because they want to draw.
Like, what is this? How?
Okay.
Definitely in term-wise, Pictionary or charades, it's just the enjoyment you can see.
So we need to come up with one.
So do we all agree on Pictionary as the most entertaining game out of the four?
Yeah.
Okay. So
yeah,
is our birthday.
Before we end the video, I actually want to ask, since we did...
We're going to talk about the game inside now. Which one do you think was the most interesting towards English? Towards our English.
Yeah,
so
I thought we were ending the video.
Like,
is it Hangman?
I don't know, like between Hangman and we had to use too much discovery.
Turn the table. I didn't realize that on my own.
Like, you need to try to trick people about form sentences, like dialogue.
Yeah. Like you
had compared to Hangman, like we used too much.
I would want to
because when I look at a Hangman. Uses your vocabulary and spelling.
Yeah.
Where something like Tutu's and Alive goes a lot of the grammar and the grammar and the structure sentence.
Yeah.
So it's really difficult now that we mentioned. I think if we in an advanced situation, Tutu's and Alive could really help someone.
Yeah, because they will learn how to speak first.
Yeah,
I mean writing, no reason. They can just change
to the communication wise.
Also listening,
she changed my mind. I think she's gonna lie.
Hey. Both for yourself. So, what about girls? Okay, so everyone said.
What a twist.
The most fun was Pictionary, and the most educated video was
Tutu's One Life. Refresh every once in a while. Play some games, and while I thought the games at the beginning were what is this? Actually playing them, you know, like that. Okay, this is fun. Involved with this. So,
thank you, everyone.
That's
and,
it.
Thank you for watching until now.
Subscribe to the
channel.
Don't forget to like.
Please do not share.
Please do not share.
Please do not share.
That's it.
Thank you.
Bye.
Yay. Bye.